Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial, and today we're looking at tracing inked art in Illustrator. I have a brand new document open here and I'm going to place a copy of my inked art. This is straight out of my notebook. So I'll choose File and then Place. I'm going to select this mason jar because this is the photograph that I took of the mason jar out of my notebook, and I'll just drag to place it inside the document. You can see the paper texture, and you can also see that this was not photographed in particularly good light, but that doesn't matter because we're able to trace it anyway. As soon as you import a bitmap image into Illustrator, and photographs of course are bitmap images, Illustrator is going to assume that you probably want to trace it. And so we can click here on Image Trace, and Illustrator will go ahead and trace the image. Now this looks like a pretty good trace, and you might be tempted to say, yep, that's fine, let's click on Expand. But let's see if we could make a better trace. So for this I'm going to the Image Trace panel. There are some advanced settings here which you can get to by clicking on this disclosure triangle, and that just expands the panel here. Depending on what you're looking for in your trace, you can now fine-tune your trace. And what I want is something a little bit simpler than this. I want to get rid of some of these wiggly outlines for the shape and smooth it down to give it a slightly different look. Well, these paths and corners are where some of those lumps and bumps are coming from. With paths, the higher the value you have, the more the paths are going to fit the original design. And I want it to smooth it a little bit, so I'm going to back off on paths. And that will simplify it quite a bit. And you could see that Illustrator retraced that as soon as I made that adjustment. Corners is a similar sort of setting. The higher number of corners you have set, the more corners they're going to be in the final art. Well, I don't want so many. I want a smoother result. So I'm going to back off corners. And Illustrator will go ahead and retrace the image with those new settings. Now, typically, it's sort of as a rule of thumb, whatever direction paths and corners go, and they'll generally go in sort of the same direction, then you want noise to go in the opposite direction, because with noise, the higher the value, the more noise we're ignoring. So I want a smoother result, so I want to ignore noise. I want to ignore bumpy edges, for example. With threshold, because we're scanning black and white here, we're going to be telling Illustrator how much of the original image it should interpret as being black and how much white. So if I adjust this to the right, we're going to say, well, more of the darker pixels in the image should be interpreted as black. And the result is, in actual fact, that everything gets interpreted as black because it was a really dark image to begin with. As I back it off, you can see that less of the image is being interpreted as black. And so you might find that some position even less than the midpoint value being 128, will give you a better result for the kind of creative look you're looking for in the trace. When you're happy with the result, and you'll want to give Illustrator a minute or two to catch up with you, particularly if you're working on a large image. Now, this image is really quite small. It didn't have to be very large for what I want it to be. But if you're working with a really large image, then you might see a delay in Illustrator completing a trace, and you want to give it plenty of time to do that. As soon as you're happy with the result, and I like what I've got here, I'm going to click here on Expand, because that converts this from a traced bitmap image into vectors. And this is what we're going to get as soon as I click Expand. Over here in the Layers palette is a layer and a group. And inside the group are the expanded shapes. So what we've got here is a shape for the inside of the bottle. We've got a shape for this part of the lid, a shape for this part of the lid. We've got a single shape at the background, which was all the white area behind the entire image. And we've got a compound path here for the jar itself. And so it's very easy for us to go ahead, for example, and color this traced scan. So I'm going to first of all get rid of this compound path at the back. It's just the white area. I don't need that anymore. I can go ahead and color my bottle. So I'll go to the swatches panel and grab a sort of dark color for the bottle itself, not quite black. Then let's go to the two pieces that make the jar lid. I'm going to make them a sort of brown color, and then the inside of the jar, which is here. And there's a simple inked image that's been traced in Illustrator. Let's try that same process, this time on a slightly more complex piece of art. I already have my document created. I'll choose File and then Place and go and grab the image I'm going to use. Once it's placed inside the document, I'll click Image Trace to start the tracing process. And it's not been particularly successful. I've lost a lot of detail in the cat, in the birds, and also in the clothing on the washing line here. So I'll go to the Image Trace panel. I'll make sure that the advanced options are visible. This time I want quite a bit of detail, so I'm going to increase the paths and also look to increase corners and see if I can bring back some of the detail in the clothing and the basket and the cat's face that I'm missing here. I'll also look at the noise setting because typically these two settings, paths and corners, will go one way and noise will go the other. And what I'm missing here is some detail that right now Illustrator is calling noise. Well, if I tell Illustrator that that's not noise, that's something that I want, then I'm going to buy back the detail in these areas and in the cat's face as well. So that's again another illustration of how when you move paths and corners in one direction and noise in the other direction, you generally get a pretty good result. Now I'm also going to look at threshold because if I increase this to the right, I'm going to be calling more of the edge data here black. So instead of it being called white, it's going to be called black. And that might help some of this edge detail be retrieved. So just going to increase that a little bit. And that's buying back a little bit more detail yet again. So it's just a case of adjusting these settings until you get what it is that you're looking for. And in this illustration, I'm looking for some detail. I want the detail in the birds. I want the detail in the cat and in the basket and in the clothes here. Now everything is ready to go, so I'll click Expand. I can close the image trace window, and what we'll expect to see in the layers panel is a single layer in the document with a group in it, and inside the group are all the elements that go together to make this illustration. Now at this stage I just want to have a quick word about a problem that you might encounter if you want to use the live paint option here. So I'm going to select over all of this art and let's choose object live paint and then make. And then let's go and get the Live Paint Bucket tool. I'm just going to click away from this so I don't have it selected. That just gets in the way a little bit. Let's go and get a color for the skirt here because that's going to be the first part of our problems. And I'm going to click to fill the skirt. And you can see here that the problem is that the colors aren't being trapped correctly. This line here is not going all the way across the skirt. And so some of the color is bleeding into the sort of waistband of the skirt. And if I want that to be a different color, then this is not going to work right now. So what I'll do is zoom into this area and I'm going to the pen tool. I'm going to grab black as my fill color and I'm going to just make a small pen shape that's going to fill in this area. Now I could spend a little bit of time working on this, but as long as it looks sort of reasonably okay, that's all I need. But you'll see that this pen shape has appeared above the group and above the live paint object. Well, if we want it to be part of the live paint object and to operate as a trap for the color, we need to put it in the live paint object. So I'm just going to drag and drop it in there. And as soon as it's dropped into the live paint group, let's go and see what we can do. I'll go back to the live paint bucket. Just going to deselect everything because I don't want to color that piece right now. And let's go and get a pale pink, and you can see that we can now isolate this area as a different area to the skirt because that piece of black that I added to the illustration is now allowing me to trap these areas separate to this one here. And so you might, in places when you've got an illustration like this that has some fairly sparse lines in it, you might need to trap things, and you might need to trap, for example, this scarf if you want to be able to fill it with color, because it's likely that this won't trap correctly. Well, this part is going to trap okay, but this part is not. So you'll probably want to put a few little extra pieces of black in the back part of that scarf so that when you go to fill it with color, the color stays within the scarf area and doesn't bleed out into the rest of the document. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.